On today's episode, this brilliant valve is in every home and it's pure engineering. Today's episode is brought to you by engineering.com, a globally trusted source for engineering content. Check out this and many other exclusive videos for the engineering professional found only on engineering.com TV today. A few of you out there will know at a glance what this nifty little assembly is. This is a solenoid controlled water inlet valve. Now this one in particular is from my long suffering 25-year-old Whirlpool direct drive top loading washing machine. So why is it in my hand instead of in my laundry room? Well, because this one has failed, requiring a replacement, and like almost every machine in my life, if it breaks, I can't resist the urge to take it apart and see what makes it work. Now, I came from the automotive industry, and I think I have a pretty good idea about good engineering design when I see it, and this particular part is outstanding. This one is made by Invensys, and it uses 220-volt solenoids to control hot and cold water flow into the tub of the washer. Now, all washing machines have these, including the modern front-loading machines. And if you've ever installed a machine, these threaded nipples protrude through the back of the machine, and they're what you attach the hoses to. Now, there are two inlets, but only one outlet, which is the key to this device. When you select the temperature control on the machine, the solenoids are programmed to cycle individually or together as necessary to blend hot and cold water to achieve the desired wash temperature. Now, obviously, some form of feedback control is necessary and is provided by this thermistor that senses temperature at the outlet before the water flows into the tub. Now, this one gave me 25 years of service and finally suffered a failure of the thermistor. So what makes this part an example of great engineering? Well, it's not only durability, as this part uses an absolute minimum of injection molded polypropylene, and it contains maybe 24 parts at most and is elegantly simple in design and operation. Now, these are the kinds of things that engineers sweat bullets to design under brutal cost constraints. And when they produce things like this, I tip my hat, because although these things are in service literally by the millions around the world, only mechanical engineers or maybe the Maytag repairman can appreciate the genius of this assembly. And by the way, one of the things that makes this assembly so brilliantly simple is that the solenoid valves are single acting. For the valves to close securely, there has to be sufficient inlet pressure from your house water system to seat the valves. So if your water pressure is low, or even if the hoses become kinked, it's possible for these valves to bypass a small amount of water, which you will see as water dribbling into the tub. So before you call the appliance repairman or tear into the back of your machine, look at the hoses and check your water pressure. But if you do need one of these, I ordered a replacement online. It's going to arrive at my home tomorrow for under $100. And compared to the cost of a lot of replacement parts these days, that's a bargain. Well, that's it for today's episode of End of the Line, brought to you by engineering.com. For our deeper engineering series, visit engineering.com TV for exclusive shows like Manufacturing the Future, Designing the Future, and the Engineering Roundtable, not found on our YouTube channel. The links are in the description below. Thanks for watching.